morning, all of you. Now we are in 3.0 lockdown third phase. So I think earlier, as I said, so mostly this online platform is the only one source to listen the classes, to run the our classes. So don't be panic. So actually you must be motivated yourself to watch the classes and to follow the daily schedule and follow these online classes properly. So if you have any doubts, you can WhatsApp me personally. So don't neglect the classes. Okay, there's only one source to listen the classes. So almost this May month, or mostly June also, we have our classes, that means here, direct classes. So then nearly these few months we will have these online classes. So we must follow these classes. So and next, of course, here this academic year is also will be extended, so no need to worry. So about the syllabus also, about the revision also. Okay, anyway, so you must follow the classes properly. Okay, so in last years we discussed that we started the reduction reactions. So among the reduction reactions, so we have completed the reduction reactions with the lithium aluminum hydride. So this lithium aluminum hydride is a strong reducing agent. Before that, it is we completed ester hydrolysis. So ester hydrolysis produces the carboxylic acid as well as alcohol. That acid medium hydrolysis is a reversible reaction, and the basic medium hydrolysis is a irreversible reaction. Okay. So of course we'll discuss some examples also. IGCH and EOH. So it is ester hydrolysis. Alkene hydrolysis of ester is nothing but saponification. And next, immediately started reduction reactions. So we have completed reduction reactions with lithium aluminum hydride. So this lithium aluminum hydride is acting as a strong reducing agent. So here that can reduce the aldehydes to alcohols, ketones to alcohols. So it is aldehydes to primary alcohols, ketones to secondary alcohols. Just it is an addition of the hydrogen. Here hydrogen addition, here hydrogen addition. Okay. So nothing but it is a hydrogenation reaction. Okay. So reduction reaction or hydrogenation reaction. Now in this case, ester is reduced to alcohol. Of course, here two types of alcohols we will get in this ester reduction reaction. And acetaldehyde is reduced to alcohol. Carboxylic acid reduced to alcohol, and that produces a H2 gas, because this H plus combines with the H plus combines with the H minus. That H minus it is from the AlH4 minus, and differently that means amides and cyanides are reduced differently from other compounds. This amide is reduced to amine. That means the CO converted to CH2, and the C triple bond N is also converted to CH3NH2. That means here two hydrogens addition takes place totally, and these hydrocarbons are converted to amine compounds with the lithium aluminum hydride. Okay, of course here we completed with the ether also, the cyclic ether with the lithium aluminum hydride produce alcohol also. Okay, that's it. Now here, so next reducing agent, that is sodium borohydride. Okay, NaBH4. This one sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride. So in this case also, Na plus BH4 minus. Na plus BH4 minus. Okay. So in this case here, this one also H minus donor. It is also H minus donor. Hydride donor. So now here in this case. So reactivity, lithium aluminum hydride is more than sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride is a weak reducing agent.
it is a less reactant. Okay, it is a weak reducing agent. Weak reducing agent. Okay, sodium borohydride is a weak reducing agent. So why it is a weak reducing agent? So generally in this case, this lithium aluminum hydride is a H minus donor, and sodium borohydride is also H minus donor. Okay, both are the H minus hydride donors. So in this case, aluminium hydrogen and this one boron hydrogen. So which is a more electron actually here? Electronegativity, boron higher than the aluminium, because down the group electronegativity decreases. So if boron has a higher electronegativity than the aluminium, aluminium less electronegative and hydrogen. So in this case here, it is a more electron positive. Aluminium is electron positive. So in this case, we have more electronegativity difference. The more electronegativity difference. Okay, because aluminium is less electronegative than the boron. That means here there is a more electronegativity difference. Okay, so in this case here, the more electronegative difference means here more negative charge on a hydrogen. That means here H minus, okay, strong nucleophile. H minus strong nucleophile. The H minus which is releasing from the AlH4 is a strong nucleophile than the H minus which is released from the NaBH4. Okay, because in this case here less electronegativity difference, less electronegativity difference. If there is a more electronic difference, more positive charge and more negative charge. Okay, so for example here this HF and here HI. So in this case here iodine electronegativity, fluorine electronegativity 4.0. This one is 2.1. So in this case 2.1. Here in this case 2.5. So less electronic difference. Less electronic difference means here less positive charge, less negative charge. Here more negative charge. Here more positive charge. That means here similarly in this case here the electronegativity of the aluminium is less than the boron. So here more electronegativity difference. Okay. For example, here hydrogen 2.1. Or suppose this one is 1.9. I think. So I am not sure about the electronegativity of the aluminum. Let us say 1.5. Of course here this one 1.9, boron electronegativity 1.9. So here less electronic difference here, 2.1. So less electronic difference means here less negative charge, less positive charge. That means here if there is a more electronic difference here, more charge separation. The more charge separation means here more positive charge and more negative charge. Okay. So here in this case, this hydrogen has a more negative charge in LiAlH4. So that is a strong nucleophile. So finally, that LiAlH4 is a strong nucleophile. LiAlH4 is a strong nucleophile. So here, that means here, it is a more reactive. Sodium borohydride is a weak, that means less reactive. It is a strong reducing agent. It is a weak reducing agent. So here in this case, aldehydes similarly reduce to alcohols, and ketones also similarly reduce to alcohols. Next, acidic halides also reduce to alcohols, but not esters, but not amides, but not cyanides. Okay, sodium borohydride, very very important, low reduction reaction. And next carboxylic acids, and next nitro compounds. Okay, these are not reduced by the sodium borohydride. Very very important point this one. So with sodium borohydride only three compounds are reduced: aldehyde, ketone, acetic halide. So already in last week we discussed the reactivity of the carbonyl compounds or acid derivatives. Okay, so generally which are more reactive? First acetic halides, next aldehydes and ketones, and next anhydrides, esters. So here esters, amides, cyanides, these are the less reactive compounds. That's a more reactive compound, aldehyde, ketone, acetic halides are only reduced by the sodium borohydride. The very very important point. But lithium aluminum hydride reduce almost all compounds. Okay, the sodium borohydride cannot reduce ester, amide, cyanide, carboxylic acid, nitro compounds. That's it.
So here this aldehyde, first suppose CH3C double bond O H. This one on reduction sodium borohydride NaBH4 with this one. In this case methyl alkyl solvent. With the lithium aluminum hydride, generally we are using either solvent. Okay? So now in this case we can use the methyl alcohol, polar protic solvent we can use, because here this H minus is not a strong nucleophile. That means it's strong, it's not a strong base. But in case of the LiAlH4, we cannot use protic solvent because here H2 gas is released. In this case, H minus is a strong nucleophile as well as strong base. But H minus combines with H plus. But with sodium borohydride, CH3OH, no reaction, no release of H2 gas. Okay, it's very one of the important point, because this hydrogen has more nature, that means more nucleophilic, more basic nature. So that H minus remove the H plus, so that gives a H2 gas. And in this case here, this hydrogen, that means here H minus release out, so that hydrogen has less nature, that means here weak nucleophile and weak base, so no acid base reaction. So we can use the protic solvent. Okay, that's it. So here what is the product in this case? CH3C OH, here H and here H. Okay, that is the product. So now here what is the mechanism of this reaction? Okay, what is the mechanism of this reaction? So generally we kill our representation of something, sodium borohydride and methyl alcohol. And next you can see this type of representation of sodium borohydride followed by hydroxys. Followed by hydroxys, what are the same? OH, H, here H. And if you water to react, call the property, one key, separate your carbon and direct your shooting ritual. Okay? That's it. So, in case of the lithium aluminum hydride reactions, now I have asked them first LiAlH4, AHF, tetrahydrofuran solvent. And next what? You are into separating chubinchum, because that lithium aluminum hydride can react with water. In case of one is separating chubinchum in a problem. So direct in a line, sodium borohydride and triacetone. Even the law of chubinchum. Okay, but with the alcohol and separating chubinchum also. In the case that does not combine with the sodium borohydride. If you would have this water on directly chubinchum also. With the reaction of elaborate. So yes, this C double bond O H. NaBH4 and water. So here CH3, OH, H here, H. And you can take water to react to all. So directly to IH. But lithium aluminum hydride case will not be separating your answer. And you can take this one combines to water. So first you add this nut and first nucleophile H minus adding to the. So second step of hydrolysis takes place. Okay? Because lithium aluminum hydride water to react to the water. Second, first lithium aluminum hydride adjacent to carbon compound. So after some time we have to add the water. But in case of sodium borohydride, we can directly add along with sodium borohydride, because there is no reaction between these two. Okay. So then what is the role of this H2? That is acting as solvent and further protonation also. So see this method. CH3C double bond O. H plus here H. From this sodium borohydride, that means here from BH4 minus, this H minus attacks on this one. So CH3C, O minus H, here H. Okay? Next, this one is hydrolyzed. So CH3, OH, H, here H. That's it. Okay? So it is a proton source now. This one will give the proton to the alkoxide layer. Okay? So here in this case, your overall reaction, the 4 moles of aldehyde is reduced by the 1 mole of the sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride plus H2. That gives 4 moles of CH3, OH, H, here H, plus sodium hydroxide, plus H3BO3, I think. Okay? So like this here, this. We can write the reaction. So total oxygens, 4 oxygens. So in this case, 4 oxygens, here 1 oxygen, here 3 oxygens, so here 4 oxygens, so 4H2.
So hydrogens, this hydrogen, four hydrogens, here eight hydrogens. In this case, this 1, 2, 3, 12 hydrogens, 12 and 13 hydrogens, 15 hydrogens. In this case, 4 hydrogens. So in this case, 4 plus this one, 8, 12 hydrogens, and this one, 16 hydrogens. Okay. So you can balance the reaction. Okay, that is the reaction rate.
So now here, for example, C double bond O H. This one I am treating with NaBD4. Okay, NaBD4. Followed by hydroxyl. So in this case, here CH3, O, here H2O, so here OH, and here BD4, D, and here H. Okay? First, suppose this one I am treating with NaBD4, and then D2O. So in this case, CH3, O, D, here H, and here also D. Okay?
So already yesterday we discussed those examples. Okay? So they are the mechanism of the sodium borohydrate reduction reaction.
I will just say with the lithium hydroxide.
Okay? So right.
This acid halide will also reduce with sodium borohydride and H2O. CH3, CH2, OH. Now, see this one. This is the keto group. And this is ester. With sodium borohydride, only ketone is reduced but not ester. That means this one, here OH, and here hydrogen. Only ketones are reduced but not esters. Now here, with the lithium aluminum hydride, LiAnH4, with lithium aluminum hydride, that lithium aluminum hydride is a strong reducing agent. So in this case, this ketone as well as ester is also reduced. So here OH, here H. This ester group is converted to CH2OH, that means here OH plus ethyl. Okay, the CO converted to CH2OH. This CH2OH. And remaining what? Ethyl alcohol. Okay? So here sodium borohydride. It is only ketones but not esters. Okay? So generally this phenomenon is known as a chemoselectivity. That means here chemically. That means in chemical reactions, selectively one group is reduced. In chemical reactions, selectively one functional group is reduced, that is a chemoselectivity. But with lithium aluminum hydride, it is a non-chemoselective. Okay, because it can reduce the esters as well as ketones. Okay, so very very important point is. For example, here write the products of this. The cyclic ester and ketone with the lithium aluminum hydride with the sodium borohydride. Okay? Sodium borohydride. Lithium aluminum hydride, SBH, generally you are writing like SBH. Okay? Sodium borohydride. So you can write the product. Now here, another one important point. LiBH4, okay, is more reactive. is more reactive than sodium borohydride. That means in this case, it can reduce LiBH4, it can reduce aldehydes, and it can reduce ketones.
can reduce acid halides, similarly sodium borohydride reactions. Now additionally it can reduce ester also. Additionally it can reduce ester also. Okay, very very important point. But with sodium borohydride esters are not reduced, but with lithium borohydride esters also reduced. Okay, with lithium borohydride esters also reduced. Okay, it's very very important. Okay, so here are all the aldehydes, ketones, acetaldehydes, esters. So here with the lithium borohydride LiBH4 esters also reduced, but with sodium borohydride only aldehydes, ketones, acetaldehydes. Yes, so very very important points. Okay, yes. So you can write the reaction with the lithium borohydride for this. Okay, that's it. So right.
Third reagent, that is diborane B2H6 tetrahydrofuran in the solvent. Okay, diborane is a reducing agent. Okay, it is a hydride compound, so it is acting as a reducing agent. Okay, it is acting as a reducing agent. In this case here, aldehyde B2H6 tetrahydrofuran followed by hydroxys. So here that is converted to alcohol, similar to the sodium borohydride and the lithium borohydride. Here this one also reduced to alcohol, and now carboxylic acid is also reduced to alcohol, and the amides also reduced to amines, and now acid halides, esters are not reduced by the diborane. It's a very very important point. Okay, so in this case here esters and acetaldehydes are not reduced by the diborane, and in this one amides are reduced to amines, and acids, carboxylic acids, can be reduced to alkanes, and here it is a more selective for acids. It's very very important point, this one, more selective for acids. So more selective for acids means here, first suppose here pH double bond O, OH, here ketone, and there is a carboxylic acid group. Here B2H6 mechanism is different. Here I am not going to discuss about the mechanism of the reactions with the sodium borohydride, sorry, with the diborane. So but here in this case that can reduce mostly carboxylic acids. Of course ketones reduce to alcohols, aldehydes reduce to alcohols. Okay, but here more selective reagent for the reduction of acids. Very very important point. Okay, so first suppose with the diborane B2H6 tetrahydrofuran, second one hydroxys. So pH double bond O, the COH converted to CH2OH. Acids are mostly reduced. So more selective reagent for the acids. Okay, first suppose this one double bond O, M CH3, and this one as yes. Okay, when the diborane B2H6 tetrahydrofuran, that's it. There is an amide function group, there is an ester function. Esters are not reduced, but amides are reduced. So that means here, in this case, see, that is the point. Because amides are converted to CO group, converted to CH. Okay, CO group converted to CH. Okay, diborane is a very very important reagent.
So aldehydes reduce to alcohols, ketones reduce to alcohols, acids reduce to alcohols, amides reduce to amides, but not acid halides and esters. It is the most selective reagent for the carboxylic acids. Okay, that's it. Right. But suppose pH, CH, double bond, CH, C double bond, no H. Next one, B2H6 tetrahead of fluorine. Okay, here aldehyde functional group is reduced to alcohol. Double bond is not affected. If only aldehyde or ketones are present, those are reduced. But if ketone and carboxylic acid are present, just carboxylic acid is reduced. Okay. So write the product of this reaction. C double bond O ester. B2H6 tetrahydro fluorine. Part of the hydrolysis of that one. And next here another long reaction. C double bond O acid. C double bond O ester. But suppose here LiBH4, I am taking LiBH4, lithium borohydride, that can reduce esters, lithium borohydride reduce esters. So here this ester is reduced, so that means that is converted to CH2OH, and now this acid is not reduced, remains same. So next is the B2H6 tetrahydrofluorine. Acids are reduced, but not esters. So here product is CHC. This one CHC. So esters are not reduced, so remains same. But acids are reduced, so CH2OH. The COH converted to CH2OH. Okay, that's that is about the diborate. Next one more reagent, fourth one, that is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Okay, that means that isobutyl means CH3, CH2, aluminium, here hydrogen, and CH2, CH3, okay? This one also can be written like this, isobutyl twice ALH, okay? Isobutyl twice ALH, or you can write like this one, CH3, twice CH2, totally twice ALH. Okay, the isobutyl aluminium hydride. This is isobutyl group. Isobutyl group. So in this case here, only one hydrogen is available. Only one hydrogen is available. Only one hydrogen is available. So here, so it can reduce partially. It can reduce partially. That means it is a
it is used for the control reduction.
It is used for the control reduction.
Of course, this aldehyde is converted to alcohol, and this ketone is converted to alcohol. Okay. And next, this glycolate, this acid halides are reduced to only aldehydes, but not alcohols. Very very important point. Esters are reduced to aldehydes, but not alcohols. And next, this amides also reduced to aldehydes. Next, this cyanides also reduced to aldehydes, okay, but not amides. Here, this amide is also reduced to aldehyde, but not amine, as in the case of lithium-aluminum hydride. Esters are reduced to aldehydes only. Acid halides are reduced to aldehydes only, but not alcohols. It is a, this diol hitch is a very specific reason for the partial reduction. Hindu general. For example, here, in case of the aldehyde, from isobutyl ALH. ALH. This H minus attacks on this one. So here O minus, here H, here H. Part of the hydrolysis that produce OH, H here, H. Okay? Followed by hydrolysis. So now here, so only one hydrogen is available. Now in case of the acid halides or esters. Acid halides or esters. Here isobutyl twice ALH. Okay? Only one hydrogen is available. So next here that the hydrogen attacks on the carbonyl carbon. So Cl and OR. Reformation of pi bond leaving off. Cl minus or OR minus. So here what is the product? Aldehyde is the only product. Further leave no more reaction because here this produce only one hydride. Okay, this one produce only one hydride. So very very important reaction. Okay, and here of course this one amide is reduced to aldehyde. Okay, I'm not saying again. Just you can remember this reaction. Okay, amides are converted to aldehydes. Okay, cyanides also converted to aldehydes. Esters are converted to aldehyde. Acid halides converted to aldehyde. But of course aldehyde. Aldehyde next only acts there. Another mole of isobutyl is added. It is reduced to the alcohol. For example here, one mole of isobutyl will get the aldehyde. So here to this compound, furtherly second mole of the isobutyl is added. That means diol is added. So that is converted to alcohol. Okay. So generally here, this aldehyde requires only one hydrogen. Ketone requires only one hydrogen. So aldehyde converted to alcohol, ketones are converted to alcohol. So acid halides, esters, amides, cyanides, just aldehyde is the product. Okay? So very very important. So right after. Okay? So diglycolides is a used for the partial reduction. Followed by hydrolysis. So then what is the product here? CH3 double bond O H already the product plus CDOH. Okay, very very important. This reaction is carried out at low temperature. That's why partial reduction takes place. That is also one of the advantages of this reaction. Okay. For example, if it is a cyclic ester, then what is the product? With a dipole H, isobutyl aluminum iron. This H minus attacks on this one. Okay. So O minus here H. This oxide. Next, reformation of pi bond, leaving out this one. So double bond O, H, here O minus, followed by hydroxys in second step. So H, this one, OH. Okay? So hydroxy, all the head is the product. That's it. So, this cyclic ester, it is the product. Now here, with the dipole H, with the dipole H, carboxylic acids are not reduced. Okay? The previous main solution, with the dipole H, carboxylic acids are not reduced. Okay? We can write the product of this reaction. Okay? Dipole H, with the dipole H. The J main question is this. I think 2014. Yes, 2014. 2015 main solution. Okay? There is ester, there is carboxylic acid. This carboxylic acid group is not reduced. No? So that's it. Okay? So dipole H is very, very important. This one. Esters are reduced to aldehydes. Acidic halides also reduced to aldehydes. So, right answer. So here one more comparison here. CH3, CH2 double bond O, this NH2 with the lithium aluminum hydride. What is the product? CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2 with the sodium borohydride, no reduction. The sodium borohydride, no reaction. With the that means here B2H6. Tetrahydrofluoro followed by hydroxys. In this case, CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2. Amides are reduced with the dipole H. With the dipole H. Second one, hydroxys at minus 75 degrees centigrade. It is converted to which one? Aldehyde. CH3, CH2 double bond O, H. That's it. Aldehyde. Okay? This is one of the complex. So important point is on. So write down. Next one. Another reducing agent. Red phosphorus plus H. You know that HA is strong reducing agent. So totally it is a strong reducing agent. Okay? Strong reducing agent. For example, this carboxylic acid first reduced to aldehyde. Carboxylic acid or ester. Whatever it is. Aldehyde is reduced to alcohol. Now here, this alcohol can be reduced to RCH. It is a complete reduction. It is a complete reduction. Ester, acetic halide, okay, or amide, whatever it is. First reduction, second step, and final step. That means here, so generally in these reduction reactions, what is the mostly product? Alcohol is the mostly product. Okay, alcohol is the mostly product. So now here, that alcohol can be converted to alkane. That means here this alkane is also removed. It's a complete reduction reaction. It's a complete reduction reaction. Okay. So red phosphorus HI is strong reducing agent. So completely we will get the hydrocarbons. That means alkanes are the products. Okay. So generally, as of now, we discussed some reactions. In those reactions, alcohol is the final product. Now here, this alcohol is also partially reduced to the alkane. That means here, this alkane is also removed. Okay. So now here, this alcohol converted to alkane RH. That means here example, CH2OH. It is converted to CH3. Now, next aldehyde is converted to CH3. This one. CO converted to CH2. Next, ketone RCH2R. Next, RC double bond O. Ester R acid halide. Ester acid halide R carboxylic acid converted to RCH3. Okay. And next one. So in this case, acid halides, esters, carboxylic acids, and this amides also reduced to alkanes. Okay. These amines also reduced to alkanes. Now here, let us discuss some amines. For example, this alcohol is converted to alkane. Now this ketone, CO group is converted to CH2 now. That means cyclohexane. For example here, CH2OH. Here CH2OH. This is a glycol. And dealing with red phosphorus and HI. What is the product here? CH3. Yes. For example here, glycerol converted to CH3, CH2, CH3. Alkane is the product. Okay. But suppose CHO, CHOH, 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 and CH2OH. What is this one? Glucose. So glucose are reduction with red phosphorus and HA. How many carbons? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbons. So totally it is converted to CH3. This one? OH converted to H2. That means CH2. Here also CH2. Here CH2. Now this one? CH3. So what is the product here? N-hexane is the product. Okay? N-hexane is the product. Okay? Red phosphorus HA is a strong reducing agent that reduces all functional groups to the alkanes. Okay, so next year, even alkyl halides also reduce to alkanes. Okay, red also. First of all, there is a glucose. Next year, CH2OH, C double bond O, CHOH, 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 and CH2OH. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, it is a fructose. Okay, fructose are reduction with the red phosphorus and HA. Then what is the product here? N-hexane is the product. Because CH2, 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 CH2. Okay? So this OH converted to hydrogen and CO converted to CH2 and this OH converted to hydrogen, so totally CH3. So there is a reduction with red phosphorus and H. The strong reducing agent.
So here finally
catalytic hydrogenation reaction. Catalytic hydrogenation reaction.
So in catalytic hydrogenation means that
the catalyst is a metal like nickel, platinum, alloy.
So it also reduces in a similar manner.
But in this case here alkenes are reduced to alkenes. You know that? And here aldehyde is reduced to alcohol, ketone is reduced to alcohol, acetaldehyde is reduced to alcohol, and cyanide is reduced to amine, and anode group is reduced to NH2, and NC, NC means here isocyanates, hydrogen addition. So here H addition, here H addition, so NHCH. Now with metal, this means catalytic hydrogenation is not suitable for the esters, amides and carboxylic acids. Esters, amides and carboxylic acids are not reduced by the metal H2. That means a nickel or platinum palladium cannot reduce this ester, amide and carboxylic acid. So very very important part. Okay? But suppose here this ketone is reduced to alcohol, that OH, HCl. Acetaldehyde is reduced to alcohol, that's it, CH2OH. Now in this case here they are not reduced by the H2 nickel, so this benzene thing is reduced. So here we will get the this product. Okay, benzene is reduced. Okay, that means here addition of the hydrogen takes place. So here hydrogen added, this hydrogen added, hydrogen added, hydrogen added, hydrogen added. Now here H2 platinum oxide. So here also carboxylic acid group is not reduced. So benzene thing is reduced. So CH2, COOH. Now with the H2 platinum, double bond is reduced, but carboxylic acid group is not reduced. The main point is carboxylic acid groups, amides and esters are not reduced by this metal H2 process. So COOH. Okay?
So that is another reaction process. So remaining reactions will discuss in second, next class. Okay?